En Frozen 2 hay una evolución en la trama y en los personajes que buscan su lugar en el mundo. Parece que los personajes han querido madurar, crecer, en paralelo a cómo lo ha hecho en estos años el público, la audiencia, ¿no?
That is true. We wanted to evolve the characters so that as our audience from the first movie grows, they can see themselves and they can see that growth in our characters. At the same time, we're still telling a movie that should be universal to everyone, including the new generation of filmgoers that will see Frozen 2 for the first time.
Y el cambio se ve no solo en la trama, sino también visualmente, ¿no? Porque en Frozen 2 pasamos del invierno total, que era la primera película, a una paleta de colores más cálidos, del invierno al otoño, ¿no?
Again, I think the autumn unfolding is partly due to our research trip, which took place in the fall, but partly the realization that as you mature, fall is a maturing of the season. It follows spring, so it's part of the evolution of our characters is reflected by the choice of the time of year.
La primera película contaba o tomaba como base el cuento La Reina de la Nieve de Hans Christian Andersen. Habéis viajado hasta Escandinavia. ¿Qué elementos habéis rescatado de cuentos populares o de mitología nórdica para armar esta secuela?
Like the first movie, which was inspired in a great deal by Hans Christian Andersen, I think the second movie continues to be so. Obviously, we tell our own original story of that, but we can't help but be inspired. Same thing with Nordic mythology, Scandinavian mythology. The worlds that they create within that mythology, we find inspiring today. And in our own way, we bring those characters into the world of Frozen 2.
En esta secuela, Anna, Elsa y compañía se van a un viaje a lo desconocido, un viaje arriesgado. Para vosotros también es un viaje arriesgado, dado el éxito de la primera película. ¿Cuándo decidisteis que era el momento adecuado para lanzar esta Frozen 2?
There's so much to that question. As far as when the time was right, it was about a year after we made the first movie that we made a short called Frozen Fever. And that taught us how much we love these characters. It reminded us how much we love these characters. And so after that began the process of trying to understand, is there more story we could tell? The venturing into the unknown, it is true, even as filmmakers, we had never made a sequel to a musical before, and that has its own challenges. So we did feel we were actually venturing a little bit into the unknown of how do we make a movie as big and as successful and lives up to the expectations that are out there and the expectations that we have ourselves as filmmakers.
Y durante, ahora que habla de expectativas, durante todo este tiempo crecían las expectativas de los fans y crecían también aquellas voces que pedían un interés amoroso para Elsa, un novio y una novia, pero esta película no trata de eso. Es inspirador encontrar una princesa que no necesite de un príncipe o de una princesa para completarse, ¿no?
I think it's true that, you know, Elsa, just at the end of the first movie, became accepted as the queen of Arendelle. And as these dangers are unleashed, albeit by her, she feels that need to protect them and carry the weight of the world on her own shoulders. So her journey is not a romantic one. Her journey is about understanding her powers, understanding what's her place in the world, and what is she meant to do.
Y para terminarle, quería que recuperáramos una imagen, la de ese un niño varón disfrazado de Elsa, con su padre, que se disfrazó también de Elsa, que demuestra que, a pesar de ser un cuento de hadas, los cuentos de hadas todavía pueden romper barreras, ¿no? Si recuerda esa imagen del niño disfrazado de la princesa.
I do remember that. I remember so what I loved about the first movie is watching people make the movie their own on YouTube videos. We were sharing them constantly ourselves. What I love is anytime you can tell a story that people can relate to, characters that people can relate to, and that they want to continue telling that story themselves at home. I think that's a wonderful thing that filmmaking can do.